Hello, this is Dr. Allen, and I will be taking you through the brain slice blocks here at Montgomery College. We're going to begin with the sagittal sections, which, as you remember, sagittal sections help to separate left versus right. And I highly recommend that you begin here on block number 4, because this is actually a mid-sagittal section where we have cut directly through the midline of the body, and it gives us a view that's almost identical to what you've been studying on the plastic model. So if you're familiar with the features here, you should have a fairly easy time identifying things with this view. One thing that I would like to point out before I start showing you features of this brain is that we've got two sides. So make sure that you choose the side where you can see things like features within the diencephalon, because that will be more similar to your plastic model. Anyway, let's get started here. So we're going to begin by looking at features within the cerebrum. Remember, the cerebrum is the outermost portion of the brain and most superior portion of the brain. And if we look within it, we can see some areas of white matter. Right here, this arching one is the corpus callosum. And then below that, I can see a line-like piece just before the diencephalon. This is the fornix. In between fornix and corpus callosum, we've got the septum pellucidum here. And this is actually a membrane that helps to close off the lateral ventricle. So in this view, I can't see the lateral ventricles, the next thing on your handout list. If it were a dissection, I'd just cut right through. So instead, I'm going to flip over my slice. And hey, now I can see an open area that's curved. It's clearly located in one of the cerebral hemispheres. And remember, the ventricles, lateral ventricles, are the only ones with that curve going on. So that helps me to be certain that this is a lateral ventricle. And as I look within it, I can see some stuff that looks almost like garbage, this little tuft of stuff. Those are actually capillaries, so that's a choroid plexus. Remember, those are the areas that make the cerebrospinal fluid that fill these ventricles during life. While we're looking at this side, because we've cut through the cerebrum more toward the outer edge or lateral edge, we can see white matter versus gray matter. So remember, the cortex, like the crust on the outside of the cerebrum, it's made of gray matter. So we've got the cortex here. I know it doesn't look very gray, but if we compare that color to what we're seeing deep to it, as we see this color change, that helps us to note the white matter versus gray matter. That's it for the cerebrum. So I'm going to flip back around so we can check out features within the diencephalon next. So looking just inferior to the fornix, I have the diencephalon right here. The major portion of the diencephalon is the thalamus. So that's this middle kind of rounded area. And then notice how it looks like there is almost an island within it. This is the interthalamic adhesion. And the indented area that looks like it's surrounding the interthalamic adhesion, that would be your third ventricle here. The hypothalamus, remember it starts with hypo, so that means below. That's this portion that looks almost like a triangle that's below the thalamus, right in through here. So we've got the hypothalamus. And then the pineal gland is actually going to be on the posterior side. I always note anterior versus posterior by looking for the cerebellum. So I can see posterior portion of the brain here, which means that looking up at the diencephalon, this would be the back side or posterior side. And what do you know? There's a little bump right there, so that must be the pineal gland. Midbrain is below the diencephalon. That's the first portion of the brain stem. So that would be the area right in through here. And notice that it almost looks like there's a little river running through it. That is the cerebral aqueduct. Anterior to the cerebral aqueduct, we have the tegmentum, one of the regions within the midbrain. Posterior to it, the region would be the tectum. So tectum versus tegmentum. Looking further down, we have cerebellum, as I noted previously. And within it, we can see lines of white matter. They're a little bit easier to see by eye, but those lines make up the arbor vitae. And then hanging off of those lines or branches, remember arbor vitae means tree of life, we have pieces of gray matter once again. So that would be more cortex here on the outside of the cerebellum. Just anterior to the cerebellum, we have another nice big open space. So that's the fourth ventricle, and that actually sits near another portion of the brainstem. I always remember the pons because to me it reminds me of a ping pong ball. So we've got the pons right here. And just inferior to that, we have the medulla oblongata, the last portion of the brainstem. Don't go too far though, because once you start to hit the end, you have hit the spinal cord with its central canal running through it. So this is brain slice number 4. We'll move on to number 3 next.